At the World Climate Summit in Scotland, one of the biggest headlines is a commitment to steep cuts in global methane emissions.
We're proposing two new rules.
Led by President Joe Biden. So what's the deal with methane, and how much will these cuts impact Texas? For answers, I'm looking at data from state and federal agencies like NASA and the EPA, and talking to a methane scientist at the University of Cincinnati, Dr. Amy Townsend Small.
Why do we care about methane?
Methane is a more powerful greenhouse gas than CO2, especially on the short term.
When it comes to climate change, you might think about methane as carbon dioxide's evil little brother. Here's why. Carbon dioxide makes up 80% of greenhouse gas emissions, according to the EPA, and it's created by the exhaust of power plants and automobiles. CO2 traps heat, making the atmosphere get hotter. And it can hang around up there for 1,000 years, according to NASA. Compared to CO2, the EPA says methane makes up only about 10% of greenhouse gas emissions and doesn't stick around nearly as long. The issue is that methane is much more potent.
On a 20-year time horizon, it's 86 times more powerful than CO2.
In other words, cutting back on a potent gas like methane would have a quick impact on climate change. But how would that play out in Texas? Well, the number one source of methane emissions is the oil and gas industry, and in that industry, Texas is number one. The EPA says abandoned and poorly maintained wells can leak huge amounts of methane. And according to the Texas Railroad Commission, which regulates oil and gas, Texas has almost 7,500 abandoned wells, like the ones Dr. Townsend's small students have tested for methane emissions in the Permian Basin. Biden's plan commits the U.S. to spending $21 billion to reduce methane emissions by 75% over 15 years by holding energy companies responsible for detecting and repairing leaks. In broad strokes, that plan is in line with a strategy already laid out by the trade group, the American Petroleum Institute.
Can you get these kinds of reductions without a lot of work coming out of Texas to get it done?
No, probably not.
So what's the deal with methane? Well, because it's a potent heat-trapping gas, cutting back now could have a rapid impact on climate change. And how much will these cuts impact Texas? Well, with 7,500 abandoned wells and billions of dollars in new government spending, there is a lot of work to be done in the Lone Star State. I'm David Schechter reporting.